I'm Eddie Stebbins, along with Charlie Mabry and Eddie Talley, and we are proud to be bringing you tonight's ball game between the Summertown Eagles and the Clifton Lions. Tonight's game is brought to you by D&D Grocery of Center, Scott's Grocery of Summertown, Community Bank and Trust of Summertown, Hughes Grocery, Etheridge Feed and Meal, Carl's TV in Columbia, Pine Knoll Landscape in Summertown, and
Etheridge Feed and Meal, hours 7 a.m. to 5 p.m., 6 days a week. Neutrino Feeds are pleased to announce that Etheridge Feed and Meal, located on Highway 43 North at Calderville Road, is now open for business. We at Etheridge Feed and Meal invite you to stop in and look over our complete line of Neutrino Feeds. We also have Rose's Dog Food. Etheridge Feed and Meal on Highway 43 North offers custom grinding and mixing. We also have nails and a full line of nuts and bolts. Neutrino Feeds and Etheridge Feed and Meal on Highway 43 North and Calderville Road will appreciate your business. Phone 829-2144. Well, Eddie, what do we expect to look at tonight in this boys' game between the Clifton Tigers and the Summertown Eagles? Lions and the Summertown Eagles.
Well, they're two evenly matched teams, in my opinion, Charlie. Both of them return several key players that have quite a bit of experience and talent. Clifton returns four starters from last year's team. Summertown returns three and sometimes four starters. So as far as experience goes, they're both very even. They're both very quick teams. A lot of athletic ability on both sides. Summertown will try to get the ball inside, where Clifton will rely more on three-point shooting and their defense to produce turnovers. So I look for a fast-paced game up and down the floor. The record in the district for both teams is Clifton has a 2-2 record and Summertown has a 1-3 record. The three losses coming mainly early in the season. Summertown playing much better as of late. So with a win tonight, they could tie for third place with a team that's already rated in the top 10 in the state.
Well, this sets the stage. We'll be ready for the starting lineup momentarily. Number 14, William Churchwell. Number 10, Sean Churchwell. Number 30, Al Buffus. Number 22, Miles Holt. Number 12, Kevin Cook. It's a starting lineup for the Clifton Lions.
Now lights are fixing to go down. The Summertown Eagles will be introduced. Number 24, the leader of this year's squad, playing guard, Greg Ivey. Number 10, Scotty Perry, another senior on this year's squad. He'll be running the floor generalship at the point guard position. Number 42 is Chris Kidd. He's coming off a fine ball game over Lewis County last weekend. He playing wing, and he's a junior. Number 52 is Rodney Long. He's the big force inside. We'll be looking to establish a game with him. And number 30, Mike Jen, a junior this year, will be another pivot player and playing a series of fine games, four or five in a row now for the Summertown Eagles.
Are we going to look for a running gun game, or are we going to slow down, set up, and play the zone, Eddie?
I believe that'll be set up by the Clifton defense. I'm looking for them to get out and run and gun. They have an extremely quick lineup. They're not blessed with a lot of size. They do have a lot of leaping ability, and they box out and position well, do the fundamentals of the game well. And as I said, they got a lot of experience on their team, so I believe it'll be up to them to control the tempo. Obviously, Coach Jimmy B and the Summertown Eagles want to put a lot of pressure on the ball and get in a run-and-gun ball game, because that's when they're at their best, when they're up and down the floor and utilizing their quickness rather than trying to set up and run the power game.
Well, it looks like Kevin Cubb's going to start. The information we had before game time that he wouldn't be starting, but it looks like he's in the starting lineup. Coach may have been trying to work a little strategy there.
Well, he's an experienced player. I couldn't understand why he wasn't in the lineup. He's been starting at Clifton since the eighth grade, the best I can remember. He's always been playing there. He's a fine athlete and a good ball player, a tremendous amount of speed. We're getting set for the tip-off here. It'll be Chris Kidd against William Churchwell.
Chris Kidd, William Churchwell in. We're getting ready for the ball to go up. And the ball is up, and the ball is controlled for Summertown. Perry, Scotty Perry. Clifton opened up into man-to-man, into low post. Long, Long missed one, taking off a Gent. Gent lays one up and in. Rodney Long got open quick that time, a little surprising.
That's a fine play. Summertown setting up in a 2-2-1 press to try to produce a quick turnover here. Clifton breaks it.
Puff working the point now out to Al Buffett. Buffett's going to work the point. Well, you really don't know who's going to work the point for them. They're running a shuffle over to Bumpus. Bumpus has Summertown opening up in the man-to-man. About a 25-footer, but William Church will. Ball comes off to Kevin Cup. Cup goes up with a shot, and he's fouled from behind by Scotty Perry. First foul of the ball game. 7:20. We played about 40 seconds. Summertown already picked up a personal foul.
Well, that's an aggressive man-to-man defense. That time we got caught with a long rebound again, Charlie. A long three-pointer came out too high, produced a bad situation underneath, and Scotty Perry got caught for a reach-in foul, but it didn't hurt us so far. Kevin Colt misses the first of his two free throws.
Kevin misses the first one. He's set for the second one. The second one's up. It bounces short. No good. The ball comes off. Picked up by Kidd. Kidd has it tipped out of his hand for Churchwell, and Churchwell dribbles on the line. Full mistake, give it back to Summertown. These Clifton boys have fast hands, don't they? They're playing full court, man-to-man press. And Perry working the ball against Churchwell. Perry brings the ball across the 10-second line over on the right base to Ivy. Ivy finds Kidd out front. He's cut off, dribbled over the left side, over to Jen on the left wing. Jen drives the middle over to Kidd. Kidd drives up the baseline. He's fouled before he takes the shot. Number 14, William Churchwell, gets their first foul of the night. Summertown puts the ball in play underneath their own basket. Perry set inbound to Ivy. Ivy driving the lane, puts up a 15-foot jump shot. It comes off. And Sean Churchwell brings the ball off and down the floor over to Cup. Cup driving the lane, puts one up and in. Kevin Cup carrying the length of the floor. Looks like we're going to see some running gunning, Eddie.
Yeah, both teams, they're no stranger to each other. Both of them are playing a good man-to-man defense. That's a fine pass to Mike Chen, who misses the shot. Cole hustling for the rebound, but he can't get to it. Fine play all around. Good hustling on both teams' part.
Summertown put the ball in play underneath it on the basket. Perry into Ivy. Ivy driving the lane, puts up a 5-foot jump shot, bounces off, no good, and the ball comes off to Bumpus. Bumpus quickly to Churchwell. Down the left side, Churchwell cut off the free throw line, back out to Sean Churchwell. Sean working the point this time over to William. William 15 foot out. Sean looking 18 foot in the middle of the cup. Cup takes, looks, cut off at the 12 foot line over to Sean. Back to Sean, 15 foot jump. It's blocked by Long. Taken off the board by Mo Holt. Holt back to William Churchwell. William drives one in, shoots a 10 foot jump shot, going in. 4-2.
A lot of fast-paced action. Both teams really getting at it on offense and the defensive end of the floor.
Perry to Ivy in the low post. Long, long. Shoots a 5-foot turnaround. It bounces, bounces. No good. Tip, but Ivy, no good. The ball goes out of bounds. Give it to Clifton.
Both teams really trying to pound the ball inside there. I'm surprised Clifton's not going to the three-point shot more and more, but right now they're trying to put the ball inside a little bit more. Here's the 2-2-1 pressure, broken easily. Oh, they missed the backdoor cut by Culp. He's wide open there. Luckily, Summertown got a break there. They sell back into the man-to-man defense now.
John Churchwell has throws the ball away. Here's second for Kidd. Kidd, 1-0-1 fast break, goes in on the left-hand side, lays her up. And we're going to give it to him. Yeah, lays her up and in, and he's fouled by number 10. Sean Churchwell, that's his first personal. 5:24 remaining, first period. Summertown 4, Clifton 4. Chris Kidd goes to the line to try to complete the three-point play. Chris to the line, it's up. Summertown has the lead, 5-4. Summertown into a full-court press into Sean Churchwell. Sean coming down the left side over into Bumpus. Bumpus on low post to Holt. Holt back to Bumpus. Bumpus back into Holt. Holt cut off over to Bumpus. Bumpus driving the baseline, puts up a 10-foot jump shot. He's fouled. We get a foul on number 24, Greg Ivy. Rodney Long blocked the shot that time, but Greg got a little wrist, they said. Must have been on the pass. That's a second personal. First personal, second team foul on Summertown. Inbounds to Bumpus. Bumpus working the left side, Churchwell. Churchwell working around to the right-hand side over on the high post. Cup, Cup driving the lane, puts one up. About a 5-7 foot jump shot. Give it to him. Fall away. Rodney Long brings up the middle of the floor, back to Perry. Perry coming across 10-second line down the left side. He's cut off all the way to the baseline. Dribbles ball out, and he's hacked on the arm by number 10, Sean Churchwell. That's Sean, second personal and third team foul on Clifton.
Charlie, looks like Sean's been on some kind of physical fitness program. He's still a fairly skinny young man, but he looks like he's put on quite a bit of weight over the summer months here.
Yeah, Sean was sort of a skinny fella last year, but he's not skinny anymore. And Ivy driving the lane, puts up a 5-foot jump shot, rolls no good. Gent clears the board, lays one up in the air. Mike Gent hustling to be in the right place.
He's been in the right place for three or four games now, Charlie, really getting on the boards well, and he's just saved us two or three ball games with his pure hustle. Not scoring a lot, but doing the things that don't get rolled up in the box scores a lot.
Well, Jason Morris coming in the ball game for Sean Churchwell. He's going out with two personal fouls for the Clifton Lions. Clifton puts the ball in play underneath their own basket into Morris. Morris over to Bumpus. Bumpus working ahead of the key over back to Morris. Morris puts one in the middle of Holt. Holt cut off out to Morris. 20-foot set. Give it to him. Jason Morris may be a three-point gunner, Eddie.
He looks like the type that just sat out there and shoot all day. I remember him playing last year. He liked to put up the long shot. He didn't quite have the touch that he looks like he has this year. It'll be interesting to see how they line up with him.
Over to Kid. Kid working the point. Over to Perry. Perry going to the baseline. He's cut off. Throws the ball back out to Ivy. Ivy runs her down to center court to Gent. Gent looking the low post. Can't find nobody. Cut off the free throw line. Perry over to Ivy. Ivy driving the baseline, and he's fouled by number 30, Hal Bumpus. That's Hal's first personal foul. Ivy on one of his patented baseline drives.
Yeah, he's got that quick first step there. Even Hal Bumpus is a fine athlete himself, but even Greg can get that first step. He's pretty well going to go by. Surprising this goal here still by William Churchwell. He's coming down the floor. Misses the layup. Scotty Perry with a rebound. Long opportunity for Clifton that time after a fine play by Churchwell.
And the long drives down the middle of the floor and lays it up and in. Fine play on the pass.
Rodney Long hustling down the floor that time. He gets the ball in there and makes a pivot move and avoid a charge. Was one of the even better play there and still made the basket.
9-9, 3:20 first period. Ball over to William Churchwell. William goes up, takes steps as he makes his move from the 18-foot line. Performance State, give it to Summertown.
A lot of pressure defense being applied, which is causing both teams to cause quite a bit of turnovers, and there they go in here. Look for them to settle down a little bit after they get used to this pressure.
Perry to Long having problems. Back to Perry. Perry working the ball across 10-second line. All the way to the free throw line. He's cut off over to Long. Driving the lane. Lays one up, and he's hammered to the floor. We're into 1-1. Number 24, Jason Morris, picks up a personal foul. That's the fifth team foul on the lines of Clifton. And Summertown goes to the line to shoot two. Rodney Long at the line to shoot two. He took charge down the lane that time.
He went to the basket with authority. Rod played a fine game over at Hornwall last week by squaring up and taking it to the basket. It was strong and using his size advantage. And scored several points. I believe he had 17 in Hornwall, and he's looking to have another big game tonight.
Rodney's second shot, it's up, it's in, and it's out. Taken off the board by Al Buffett. Clifton quickly down the floor over to Morris. Morris takes another three-point shot. It's no good. Taken off the board by Churchwell. Churchwell hits inside Bumpus. Bumpus cut off. Back out to Churchwell. Over to Al Bumpus. Bumpus cut off 15-foot line. Lays one up. It's no good. Tip. Bumpus no good. Ball comes off. Ivy made a great play battling the ball off one of the Clifton boys on the jumping.
Give credit to several Summertown boys there. Chris Kidd and Mike Gent both tipped the ball twice to keep it alive, and Greg Ivy with a pure hustle play jumped out of bounds, avoiding going out of bounds himself, and throws the ball off of William Churchwell. Greg, a fine hustling play.
Perry into Kidd. Kidd over to Ivy. Over to Perry, and the ball bounces off. He wasn't expecting the pass back.
Not that quick.
Bounced off his body.
It's a simple man-to-man four-court pressure. We just need to get a man open and get back to Scotty and clear out, and there won't be no problem to break this press as of right now.
Bumpus over to Morris. Morris back out to William Churchwell. Churchwell looking for Morris to head the circle. Over to Bumpus, Al Bumpus. And Churchwell working outside against the tough man-to-man defense. Al Bumpus on the right side in the high post. Miles Holt has the ball blocked, taken off for Chris Kidd. Summertown brings the ball down Scotty Perry looking for something to happen on right wing. Right baseline to Ivy. Ivy cut off over to Long at the 18-foot line. Back to Ivy. Ivy working down the middle, going down the middle of the lane. Goes up for a 5-foot jump shot. Has the ball stripped. Taking off to Al Bumpus. Dribbling length of the floor. Puts one up. 5-foot jump shot. Give it to him. Things just went placid that time, ain't it?
Nobody picked Al up. He was looking not to charge and run over anybody, but nobody picked him up. He simply went all the way with a simple 2-foot jumper and nailed it home.
And the long to Kid. Kid trying to pass into Ivy. Ball's picked up by Jett. Jett working, cut off the wing, back to Perry. Perry just tried a 20-foot jump shot. It's knocked up in the stands by William Churchwell.
Scotty seen William coming that time. He came from the blind side with perfect timing with a rejection. The ball goes out of bounds. Summertown will be bringing it in.
Dan Devers is in for the Clifton squad.
Coach Doug Lambert of Clifton, since it's a game being a fast-paced game, he's substituting freely inside.
Long goes in for a layup, and he's fouled by Kevin Cuff. That's Kevin's first personal line. And Rodney Long going to the line with authority, going to the basket with authority tonight, Eddie.
He's posting up very well, getting the person on his head right where he wants him, and give credit to the wingman for getting the ball to him when he needs it down there. He's got him on his hip, and he's simply wide open to go to the basket. It requires somebody else to switch off their man. That time, Culp was a little late in getting there and setting up, and he picks up a blocking foul, his first.
Rodney at the line to shoot two. Clifton has a one-point lead. First one ties the ball game with 1:22 remaining. In the first period, it's 11-11. And Rodney at the line attempting to give Summertown the lead again. It's up. It's also good. 12-11. Quickly, Al Bumpus cut off 10-second line over to Churchwell. Churchwell into Cup. Driving the middle of the lane. Puts up a 10-foot jumper. No good. Ball taken off by Bumpus. And Bumpus is fouled by Perry on the rebound. Evidently, Perry hooked him on the arm as you come around. That's Scotty's second personal foul. We can't afford to lose our ball handler this early in the ball game.
Scotty has been a key to our success all year. He's got to be the man in there to run the offense. Look for him to kind of back off on his defense a little bit with 1 minute left in this first quarter here.
And the bump is over to Morris. Morris back out to Churchwell on the left wing. Morris 22 feet out. Bumpus in the low post to Cup. Cup makes a move down the middle, taken off the board by Ivy. Ivy quickly coming down the left side. He's going to slow her down, and then he's going to take down the middle, take up 10 foot into Kid. Kid has the ball battled around and goes out of bounds off Clifton. Give it back to Summertown.
Some fine interior passing and some close quarters there by Greg Ivy and Chris Kidd, knowing each other very well and make a pass. Unfortunately, it was tipped out of bounds by Clifton. Summertown with the ball in bounds now.
And the long driving ahead of the circle, cut off. Perry out, cut off 10-foot line into long cut off at the baseline out to Ivy. Ivy 22 feet out. We're going to set her up again. Perry down the middle, lays one up. It bounces out. Kid at the right place, picks the rebound off. Lays it up. It's no good. Take it off of William Churchwell. We had a couple of bad bounces. Ball stolen by Perry, and we have a foul. Another foul on Scotty Perry. That's Scotty's third personal of the night. He was a victim of circumstance that trip, Eddie.
That's a critical call there, coming down the floor like he made a fine defensive play, but unfortunately the ref on the backside didn't think so. He thought he had a little bit of arm there, so he's going to have to sit down the rest of this half. Be interesting to see how Kelly Clark, number 22, who replaces him, handles the pressure. He's not been in these real big ball games this early. Be interesting to see how he handles it.
That's the fourth team foul on Summertown. Next time, Clifton will be in the 1-1. They worked ahead of the circle over to Morris. Morris working on the right side to Churchwell. Churchwell 30 feet out. Bumpus.
Got 9 seconds, Leo.
9 seconds in the quarter. Bumpus bringing her in. Takes up a 15-foot jump. No good. Jent brings the ball off the board. And as first quarter comes to an end, Summertown 12, Clifton 11. Hughes' Grocery, Highway 20 and 43. Hughes' Cash and Carry, Highway 20. Wayne and Linda Hughes are the owners of these stores, and they offer a full line of groceries, gas, diesel fuel, and kerosene. They feature hot deli with hot coffee, sausage and biscuits, ham and biscuits, hot dogs, sandwiches made to order. They also have pocket knives, gifts, and toys. Video rentals are $3 for $5 every day. Rent on Saturday and keep until Monday. Wayne and Linda are open from 4:30 to 6, 6 days a week. Start the second period. Clifton brings the ball in into Bumpus. Bumpus is bothered by Ivy. Stripped away by Ivy. Ivy going all the way. Lays one up. It rolls off and no good. And on the rebound, Jason Morris had the position and he's fouled by Kelly Clark on the hustling rebound. Greg just can't get things going his way tonight.
Greg's seeing someone as quite a bit as quick as he is. He's frustrated right now. He made a fine play right there going in. He did miss the layup. But for Greg Ivy, he's got a lot of heart. I predict the next time down the floor if Summertown has the ball, he'll be the one to put the shot up if at all possible.
Greg Morris, Jason Morris at the line to shoot the 1-1. First one's up. It's good. We have a tie score with 7:48 remaining second period, 12-12. Summertown High School Gymnasium, homecoming tonight. Second one's up. It's also good. Clifton takes a one-point lead. Kelly Clark going to run the offense for the Summertown boys. See how he handles the pressure over on the right wing to Ivy. Ivy cut off out to Clark. Clark 25 feet to Ivy. On the low post to Gent. Gent sneaks in behind him, and Mike laid one up and in.
Clifton went back into a 2-3 zone that time with some substitutions they have. They took out Sean Churchwell and Kevin Colbert. There's a steal by Greg Ivy. He goes in, misses another jumper inside. Kelly Clark fighting for the rebound, goes off his leg out of bounds. Fine play.
Greg Ivy is having a hard time. He'll get her together. We have a timeout on the floor. 7:20 remaining second period. Summertown 14, Clifton 13.
Chapman's Radiator and Machine Shop on Brace Road, Mike Chapman being the owner, is open from 7:30 a.m. to 5 p.m. 6 days a week. If you have radiator problems, Mike will recoil your radiator. If this can't be done, he will sell you a new radiator. Mike also sells heater coils. They offer welding repair and fabrication, also lathe and machine work.
We're about to put the ball back in play, Clifton. Into Bumpus. Al Bumpus working up the right side. Going across the middle. He only has token pressure from Greg Ivy. Drives down to the baseline. He's cut off over to Morris. Morris stolen by Kidd, but he hit it a little far. He's got to hold up. Driving the baseline now. Chris Kidd lays one up and in.
He's just going to hold up from slamming it, Charlie. He's still looking to go to the basket anytime there's an open. That's a good anticipation switching defense that time of Chris Kidd.
Over to Bumpus. Summertown double teaming Bumpus. It looked like it's paying off. Over to Churchwell. William Churchwell double team. Picked off by Ivy. Ivy driving the length of the floor. Lays one up. This one goes in.
Summertown picking up the defensive intensity here with a couple of Clifton starters on the bench here. It's resulting in some quick turnovers.
Over to Churchwell. William Churchwell hits Devers. Devers out 10-foot jump shot. It's no good. Mark Gent comes out with the ball. Summertown's opened up a 5-point advantage in the last few seconds. Ivy bringing the ball up, calling for Clark. Clark takes it ahead of the circle, works it to the left side over baseline to Kidd. Out to Ivy, over on right wing, Gent. Gent cut off on the baseline over to Ivy. Ivy has the ball tipped out of bounds by Jason Morris.
For the ball handling problems, Clifton's been experiencing. Sean Churchwell, number 10, their ball handler, is coming back in, replacing Jason Morris. They also settle back into a 1-3-1 defense, it looks like.
Kelly
sagging
Clark
toward the goal.
Kidd over to Gent. Gent comes back out on a high post. Long has the ball stopped. And we have a foul on the drive on William Churchwell. That's William's second personal foul. That's one of the Hosses. If we could get about three on him this quarter, Eddie, we'd be looking up.
He's been doing a fine job in the game so far, but Clifton has a balanced attack. They can go to four or five different people to get their scoring there, but it would be nice to get him on the bench early in the game.
Rodney Long going to the foul line several times tonight, Eddie, in this first half, so maybe the trend will continue. But he's playing aggressive tonight.
He's posting up well and giving people a lane to give him a pass, and when they throw it to him, Rodney's catching it and turning and going to the basket with it.
20-13, 5:58, second period. Into Bumpus. Al Bumpus working the backcourt. He gets Greg Ivy, brings the ball across 10-second line. When they get across 10-second line, we're double-teaming. Bumpus down the left side. He's cut off over to Sean Churchwell. Sean over to William. William Churchwell trying to find the inside over to Bumpus. Bumpus, 15-foot jump shot. It's no good. Ball taken off by Long. Summertown had three men on the rebound that trip.
Summertown doing a fine job of boxing out and getting position that time. resulted in a good rebound. The ball didn't bounce the best of the ways, but we had plenty of men there.
Ivy, a 22-foot jump, no good. Ball taken off by William Churchwell. Over to Sean Churchwell. Sean driving the length of the floor. It's up, no good. And the ball goes out of bounds off of Clifton. We got the back riding on one end, then another, Eddie. That's all we can say.
As long as we get the ball that time, that's all right, Charlie.
That makes two or three opportunities they've missed on a layup now. Over to Kid Clark. Clark driving the middle. He's cut off, has the ball stripped. Picking up by Dan Devers. Devers over to Churchwell. Churchwell holding the ball up 15 feet out over to Miles Holt. Holt, 30-foot jump shot, no good. Well, the ball out of bounds, give it to Summertown. Looks like a little goaltending. They were playing with it on the rim, but the official didn't see it.
In fact, that ball's still in the cylinder to me, and with the fine athletic ability of William Churchwell, I thought he interfered with it, but the official didn't call it, so it doesn't count as a goaltend.
Over to Clark. Clark on the high post, long. Has the ball stripped away by Churchwell. Churchwell bringing her down the floor. Cut off at the 30-foot line. Guarded closely by Clark. Back over to Bumpus. Bumpus in the low post. Back out to Bumpus. William Churchwell over to Sean. Sean trying to make a move. Almost has the ball picked off. Bumpus pummeling it around. 15-foot jump shot by Sean Churchwell. Give it to him. He worked the seam. Got loose in the middle.
Clifton showing a lot of patience that time, waiting to just the right moment to get their shot. Well, they got a little bit of an advantage, and Sean being a little quicker than Kelly, he's trying to guard him there. Let's see if they try to take advantage of that.
Summertown built a 5-point lead over to Jim, back to Ivy. Ivy working a high 20 feet out over to Clark. Clark in the corner. Kid throws the ball away. It's sent to William Churchwell, and he's grabbed by Greg Ivy, and that's Greg. Second personal, so we'll go to the line to shoot the 1-1.
Summertown trying to force some cross-court passes there. They look like they're open with the fine athletic ability of this Clifton team and their quickness. They're able to get out and get those, which they've been open all year for us, but we're going to have to settle down and make sure we swing the ball around through the proper passing lane.
William Churchwell to the line to shoot the 1-1, 20-15. Summertown with the advantage, 20-16 with 3:51 remaining in the second period. William Churchwell to line, complete the 1-1. Second one's up. It's good. Clifton in their full court press. Clark looking for somebody, finds Ivy. Ivy back to Clark, to Ivy. Ivy working the back court, coming across 10-second line with three guards on him. Cut off the head of the circle, over to Clark. Clark over to Gent. Gent cut off the 18-foot line, back to Clark to Gent. Gent in the baseline, has the ball, quick hands again, has the ball slapped away, out of bounds by Bumpus.
Clifton sensing that Scottie Perry being out of the ball game is really our best ball handler. They really picked up their defensive intensity. They put a full court 2-2-1 press on us that time and really playing hard half court here. So
over to Gent on the left wing, in the corner to Clark. Clark dribbled in about 15 feet, cut off again over to Kid. Kid into Ivy. Ivy takes a 5-foot jump shot. It's no good. Rodney Long clears the board, lays one up, and it rolls in and out.
But there's a monkey on that rim down there.
It's about to get rough. Over down to Sean Churchwell. Sean's cut off the free throw line. We have a 3-second call. 3:01 remaining second period. Summertown 20, Clifton 17. Eddie Clark's trigger man in the long, back to Clark. Working over the long, somebody's open, Ivy in the kid lays one up and in. Greg Ivy made a brilliant pass from midcourt.
Summertown showing a lot of patience that time, getting the ball in the middle of the floor, and that's the way you break a four-court press. You get the ball to the man in the middle, and that opens up a lot of alleys. We had a 3-on-2, and Greg Ivy spots Chris Kidd with a fine pass, resulting in 2 points. Beautiful play.
William Churchwell working outside, looking for something to happen, over to Al Bumpus. Bumpus 30 feet out, hitting on low post to Cup. Kevin Cup has the ball spotted, picks it back up, lays it up, no good. And Kevin Cup, William Churchwell, tips one in. Everybody on the board. And Ivy got 3-on-1, and Gent takes a 10-foot jump shot. It rolls, no good. Tip by Gent, no good. Taken off the board by Dan Devers. Quickly down the floor is Churchwell. Churchwell cut off by Kid. Kid over to Churchwell. Churchwell back 18-foot jump shot. It's no good. Ball comes off the board, taken by Ivy. Ivy bringing her up to the left side. He stops the free throw line to Clark. Clark on the right wing has the ball intercepted. Goes out of bounds. By the quick hands of Sean Churchwell, Summertown set the inbound on right front court. Chris Kidd. Long comes out high, intercepts pass over to Kidd. Another dangerous pass. Ivy working left wing. 1:30 remaining in the second period. Summertown just trying to find the open man. Gent, Ivy. Ivy has the ball stripped by Sean Churchwell. Sean lays one up and in this time.
Got a little nonchalant. You can't do that when Sean Churchwell's anywhere around. He can pick your pocket about any time.
And the Gent lays one up, and it's no good. William Churchwell brings the ball off the board. Clifton's within one with a minute 5 remaining out. Churchwell to William. William driving the lane, lays one up, gives Clifton the lead.
Clifton putting on a quick run here at the end of the first half here, and that's a reach-in foul on
Dan Devers.
That'd be his first foul. Summertown in the 1-1. They'll be going to the line. That'll be Kelly Clark to shoot the 1-1. Number 22, Miles Holt, returns to the lineup. And number 24, Jason Morris, comes in. Coach Doug Lambert taking some of his key players out so that they won't pick up an extra foul for the half ends. For Summertown, Jason Campbell, number 12, comes in, takes out Greg Ivey. That's for the same reason, that he won't pick up a foul here.
Kelly Clark at the line to shoot the 1-1. Clifton holds a one-point advantage with 52 seconds remaining in the half. First one's up. It's no good. Taken off by Sean Churchwell. Sean dribbles ball down the floor, cut off in backcourt. Looking for somebody over to Cup. Cup cut off 18 feet out. Looks like we're going to play for one shot. They're running the Reeve out front. Sean Churchwell 35 feet out, waiting on somebody to come get him. Over to Morris. Morris. Al Bumpus. They're working the weave out front. He rolls the ball and he travels. 21 seconds remaining. Floor mistake. Little Campbell caused a floor mistake that time. Eddie?
Yeah. He got in there and did his job well. And now with only 21 seconds left, Coach McBee brings back Scotty Perry and Greg Ivey, the two seniors. We'll be looking to take one shot. Try to go into halftime with a 1 or 2 point lead.
He's given the one shot signal into Ivy over to Perry. Perry worked 35 feet out to Kidd.
We got 10 seconds. They'll be starting to work for the play.
Ivy, the Kidd takes a 15-foot jump shot. It's no good. Ball comes off to Ivy. Ivy to Kidd. Kidd, 15-foot jump shot. It's no good. Come off the board as the first half comes in. Summertown 22, Clifton 23.
Ettridge feeding meal with hours 7 a.m. to 5 p.m. is happy to sponsor Summertown High School basketball on Channel 10. Ettridge feeding meal located on Highway 43 North at Camelsman Road, serving all of northern Lawrence County, features a complete line of Neutrina feeds. We also have roses, dog, and cat foods. Ettridge feeding meal offers custom grinding and mixing for the customer's convenience. Neutrina feeds and Ettridge feeding meal on Highway 43 North and Camelsville Road invite you to stop in today or phone 829-2144.
Carl's TV and Movie Rentals, located on Nashville Highway in Columbia. Carl Wilkerson has a full line of RCA televisions, from the big 58 screen down to the 5.5-inch color monitor. Carl offers RCA video camcorders at affordable prices. Also a full line of VCRs and accessories. Carl's TV has a movie rentals suitable for the entire family, open to 9 p.m. each night. All of our equipment came from Carl's TV in Columbia. scoring run down for the first half. First for the Clifton boys with 23. William Churchwell has 8. Sean Churchwell, 4. Kevin Cupp, 4. Al Bumpus, 2. And Jason Morris with 5 points. Makes 23. The foul load, William Churchwell, 2. Sean Churchwell, 2. Kevin Cupp, 1. And Al Bumpus, 1. Jason Morris, 1. Dan Devers, 1.
For Summertown, Chris Kidd had 7 points. Greg Ivey was limited to only 2 points. Rodney Long, 7. And Mike Gent, 6. For the foul load, Scotty Perry is in foul trouble with 3 fouls. Greg Ivey has 2 fouls. And Kelly Clark, 1. And Summertown scored halftime, 22 points.
D&D Grocery Center, David and Diane Bailey, is a one-stop shopping center. They're open from 5:30 to 8. They're open 7 days a week. We have a full-line snack bar with pizza and old-fashioned hamburgers and all kinds of snacks. D&D is your headquarters for your hunting and fishing equipment and license. That's D&D Grocery in Center. Well, as we get ready to start the second half, now looks like both teams are bringing their starters back in, so we should be able to pick up right where we left off. Summertown brings the ball in play on alternating possession. Perry over to Ivy. Ivy working the right side. Old Kidd to left on the baseline. Gent. Gent takes a 10-foot jump shot. Give it to him. Looks like we're going to work baseline to baseline.
That's pretty well what's been open. They're trying to play a funky zone. They start out in a 2-3 and then they'll switch to a 1-3-1. It's just a kind of a matchup type deal where they just try to pick up a man in their area. That's a shot by Al Bumpus, no good. Chris Kidd fighting for the rebound. He comes away with it. Summertown clears to Scotty Perry and bring it up the floor now.
Those long arms brought that rebound down. Yeah. Over to Kidd, over to Ivy. Ivy driving the lane, lays one up wide open and missed another. Gent comes in, powers the board off of layup. Greg just snake bit tonight. He can't get a roll, but we got somebody to back him up. Over to Churchwell. Churchwell puts up 15-footer, no good. Gent diving for the ball, comes up with it. We have a jump ball, alternating possessions. Goes to Summertown. Goes to Clifton, which is right. Dan Devers in for the Clifton boys, replacing Miles Holt. A little controversy on who's supposed to have the ball. I don't think they changed the signs on the inbound pass.
That's what happened. We started off the quarter with the ball. It's Clifton's turn to have the alternating possession.
It's right now into Churchwell. Sean Churchwell 30 feet out over to William. William guarded closely by Kidd. Over to Al Bumpus. Al over to William Churchwell. 22-foot jump. It's no good. Devers puts the ball off the board, puts her up and back in. Dan Devers, tall boy off the bench. Summertown over to Ivy. Ivy quickly brings the ball across 10-second line. Sets up to Perry over to Ivy. Perry working the right side. Gent down the right baseline. Has the ball tipped out of bounds by Al Bumpus. Al has those long arms and quick range. So
they're really putting a lot of pressure on Summertown. William Churchwell is doing a fine job of fronting Rodney Long inside. That was open all the first half, and Rodney got 7 points out of it.
Over to Jen on the left baseline. Over to Ivy on the right wing. Ivy making his drive. Takes a 15-foot jump shot. Give it to him. Maybe Greg will get cranked up here. Summertown with a 3-point lead. 6:10 remaining, third period. Sean Churchwell in the low post to Cupp. Kevin Cupp cut off. Back to Sean. 22-foot jump shot. Got the air ball. Al Bumpus brings the ball off the board. No good. Brings it off again. Puts one up, and he's fouled by number 42, Chris Kidd. That's Chris's first personal of the night. And Al Bumpus goes to the line to shoot 2. Looked like he might have got all ball that time, but the way the situation was, the way the official was cut off, you're automatically going to get the call.
I believe it was hammered by someone. We had 3 men around him there. Maybe Chris had all ball, but it looked like somebody had a little body on him in there. Anytime you get up with 3 people on you like that, most of the time a ref will call a foul on someone there.
Bumpus puts the second shot. It's good. Summertown lead cut to 1. Perry in the long. Long cut off over the midcourt to Kidd. Kidd to Gent. Gent takes a 12-foot jump shot. It's no good. Ball off the board to Cupp. Kevin Cupp quickly up the board. Bumpus over to Bumpus. Bumpus driving the baseline. Lays one up. And he's fouled by Rodney Long. Rodney picking up his first personal of the night.
Summertown a little lazy and getting back down the floor that time, getting enough, everybody matching up with their men, and wound up picking up another cheap foul. And Al Bump was recognizing and taking into the basket and causing Rodney Long to pick up his first foul.
Line to shoot two. That ties the ball game at 28, 5:42, third period. Al Bumpus at the line for the second of the one and one, or the two-shot foul. It's up, it's bottom. Clifton takes the lead once again. They're still in their full-court press, giving Summertown all kind of problems. Perry in the middle, Ivy has the ball slapped away by Bumpus. Boy, they have quick hands.
Fine athletic ability on that. You don't see many people picking Greg Ivy's pocket like that, but they're fine athletes with good quickness there.
Thing over, he's 6 feet away from him when he picks it. Into Long, lays one up and in over Bumpus. Yeah, they're 6 feet away when they pick the pocket. Clifton brings the ball away into Churchwell. Churchwell dribbling 35 feet out over to Bumpus. Bumpus cut off the baseline, back to Churchwell, back to William Churchwell. William over to Deaver. Deaver on the high post to Bumpus. Kevin Cup. Cup lays one up, no good, taken off by Rodney Long. Summertown quickly down the right side over to Kid. Kid, 22-foot jump shot. Long, no good. Ball goes up. Ivy is in position. Rebound, and he's pushed by Kevin Cup. That's Kevin's second personal of the night. Greg Ivy was wide open that time, and all he wants, he went flying out of bounds.
We're having a real fast-paced game tonight, Charlie. The score doesn't indicate that at all. A lot of times teams score this much in one quarter, but having a real fast-paced game, it's just a good defense on both sides to prevent the score from being ran up.
Ivy driving the baseline, 7-foot jump shot. Greg Ivy getting heated up now. He's hit two in a row out there. Summertown with a three-point advantage, 4:48, third period. Al Bumpus cut off the baseline, tries to feed the middle, picked up the pick. Perry crossed 10-second line, goes to the head of the circle, tries to feed the middle to Ivy. Ivy takes a 5-foot jump shot, knocked up in the stands by Al Bumpus that time.
Al sitting back there. Greg Ivy normally gets that shot off with ease there. He neglected the fine leaping ability of Al Bumpus, and now let him know he can jump.
Over to Perry. Perry set for a 20, and the kid. Kid running the baseline. We have a foul away from the ball on the baseline on Chris Kidd. That's Chris's second personal foul. He didn't hold up his drive after he gave the ball away, and Bumpus was set. That's Chris's second personal tonight. Summertown in the full court press over to Sean Churchwell. Sean brings her across down to the left side. Cut off by Perry. Out, tried to feed out front, and he's fouled by Perry, Scotty Perry. That's Perry's fourth personal foul.
I believe the foul's on Sean Churchwell of Clifton that time, Charlie.
Sean Churchwell, that's Sean's third personal foul. That is a big turnaround.
Yeah, so Scotty goes out with four right now. We're going to be in some bad shape for a little bit. We really need him in there. He's not scored a point yet, but so many times the people not doing the scoring are really more valuable to the team than the person actually doing the scoring, and Scotty's evidence of that tonight.
So Sean goes out with a third personal. Work around the key. Ivy driving the baseline. Has the ball stripped away. Picked up by Devers. Devers bringing it over to William Churchwell. Churchwell over to Morris. Morris has the ball dropped up in the stands by Chris Kidd. Ivy thought he was shoved out of bounds that trip down the floor, and he just let the ball go.
Yeah.
Which he probably was, but he didn't get the call. Clifton set the inbound, Churchwell into Bumpus. Bumpus working 22 feet out over the head of the circle. Driving over to William Churchwell. He's guarded closely by Kidd over to Bumpus. Bumpus 16 feet. Morris back to Bumpus. Bumpus driving the lane. He's cut off the baseline. Ball's tapped away by Ivy and retrieved by Ivy.
I believe the no call really got Greg fired up down there. He really played some fine defense that time in Bumps' face, and it even resulted in a turnover there.
And the Perry, 22-foot jump shot, no good. Kidd takes the ball off the board, lays one up, and in. And he's fouled by number 34, Dan Devers. No, he's fouled by Kevin Cup. That's Kevin's third personal foul. I'm glad he's seeing better than I am. We have Miles Hope into the ball game now for Kevin Cup. So Chris Ivey goes to the line to try to complete the three-point play. Summertown's opened up a five-point lead with 3:31 third period. Make it a six-point lead. Into Bumpus. Bumpus cut off over to Morris. Morris working the point for Clifton Lions. Working over to the right side. He's cut off in the middle of Churchwell. Churchwell, 15-foot turnaround. He got high and low and got her.
That's a fine shot by William Churchwell. That's a hard shot to defend. If he starts knocking that down, Summertown will have all sorts of problems defending that.
Perry bringing the ball across. 10 seconds. Over to back to Perry. Perry cut off to Kidd. Kidd 22 feet out. Gent. Gent in the low post. Long. Rodney Long lays one up and in. The whole Summertown team is hustling. Tonight they seem to want this game a little more than Clifton does, I believe, at this point.
So far they've really shown some good enthusiasm trying to stay. I just hope that Coach McBee's not doing any substituting unless someone gets in foul trouble. Let's hope the fatigue factor doesn't come into play in this fast-paced game here.
William Churchwell puts up a 25-foot shot and draws air. Ball goes out to Summertown over to Kidd. Kidd quickly across 10-second line, takes a 10-foot jump shot. Banks her off the board. That's about like Mike Rhodes' shot. Banks her off the board.
Mike Rhodes used the backboard quite often. It's a fine, high percentage shot. It allows you more air.
William Churchwell goes down the middle, and he's fouled by Kidd. Kidd just standing there, and Churchwell blowed him over, and he gets the basket. Mike Gent gets the foul. That's Mike's first. Basket counts, and he goes to the line to shoot the one.
Coach Doug Lambert once again sensing the fatigue factor, possibly substitutes Sean Churchwell, number 10, in for Al Bumpus, number 30, as William Churchwell completes the three-point play.
Cuts the lead to six. Summertown back into Perry. Perry with three men on him over to Ivy. Ivy coming across the middle of the court. Held up the free throw line. Bumped all out, no foul over to Perry. Perry 22 foot out. Takes a 22-foot jump shot, no good. Ivy brings one off the board, puts it up, no good. Ball batted around. Perry brings the ball up. Stolen by Churchwell. Churchwell over to William, and William lays one up and in.
Summertown just can't seem to get the layup to go down there tonight. They had three or four opportunities that time, and they just couldn't get it to go down. And winds up with some fine teammate from the Churchwell brothers and coming up with 2 points for Clifton.
These Clifton boys are coming out of nowhere making the steal. Summertown not used to that. Perry tries a low post pass. It misses. Picking up by Sean. Sean driving in 10 foot. Take a 10 foot left hand jump. No good. Ivy clears the board. Greg brings her off. 1:29 remaining third period. Summertown 39. Clifton 36. Ivy working to the left side into the low post to Rodney. Rodney's hacked by William Churchwell. That's William's third. Rodney trying to make a pass across the lane. He's hacked on the arm by William Churchwell. Summertown not in the bonuses yet. Al Bumpus coming back in to replace Miles Holt. Summertown put the ball in play on side court. That seems like we're going to be in the 1-1. So Rodney Long bit the line to shoot the 1-1. Is this his first trip to the line in the third period?
In the third period, it is his first trip to the line. I believe it's the first trip for anybody is on the Summertown trip to the line there.
He was at the line several times during the first half.
Seemed to be some confusion on the floor here as to whether or not it's a 1-1, but official Henry Phillips confirms that it is a 1-1, and Rodney will be at the line to shoot the 1-1 for Summertown.
Rodney Long, we're getting a little breather here. This little breather may help us out on stamina later in the ball game. Rodney's first shot, it's up. It's good. 40-36, 1:21, third period. Rodney trying to stretch the lead to five. And he does. Clifton quickly up the floor. Sean Churchwell into Devers, into Morris. Morris into Devers. Devers cut off over to William. William, 15-foot jump. He knocks the glass too, Eddie.
I wonder if that was on purpose there. It looked like a fine shot, but normally William doesn't use the backboard from that far out.
They got a tough man full court press. Summertown floor mistake with 57 seconds remaining in the period.
Summertown seeing the open pass. They're just not making the right pass to get it there. Throwing just a little bit long on two or three occasions. Mike Jent that time not able to handle the feed from Scotty Perry.
Churchwell feeds the middle of Bumpus. Al Bumpus lays one up. It rolls off. Chris Kidd brings the ball across off the board. Summertown down 44 seconds into Ivy. Ivy driving the length, driving the baseline. We have a whistle. We pin the ball to the board. It's going to be Summertown's ball. It's going to be Summertown ball under its own basket.
Did they hit the ball on the backboard that time, Charlie?
We pin the ball to the bottom of the board, which is strictly fair if you get it going up. And the ball never did get any higher. He got it at the top and pinned it. So it shouldn't have been a whistle, but they had to do something after a whistle, so they gave Summertown the ball. Play should have continued. In the Gent cut off on low post into Ivy. Ivy driving lane, lays one up and in. Turning, twisting move by Greg Ivy. Lays one up and in, brings her back to five.
Greg trying to be careful not to draw a charge that time. Successfully done it with 20 seconds. Clifton will not play for the one shot. Instead draws a foul on Scotty Perry. What a call by the referee.
Sean Churchwell goes up for a shot, and that's the fourth foul on Scotty Perry. Looks like we're picking up the foul on that end, but get down to the other end, we're not picking up the foul too well.
It's like there's a lot of anticipation whistles there. It looked like Scotty was going to commit the foul, but I thought he faded away from him, but it seemed the ref kind of got caught in blowing the whistle and had to make a call there. But nevertheless, that's going to be four fouls on Scotty Perry, and Sean Churchwell goes to the line as Kelly Clark comes in to replace him.
16 seconds remaining in the quarter. First one up, it's good. 43-39. Sean Churchwell toeing the mark. A little left-hander, about 6 foot. Left-hander jumping jack. It's up. It's in and out. No good. Chris Kidd clears the board. Over to Kelly Clark. Kelly brings the ball down, and he's bumped by Al Bumpus. That's Al's second personal foul. He just stopped in front of him, and Bumpus just ran over him. So Kelly Clark goes to the line to shoot the one and one.
Only 11 seconds left. Clifton should have the last shot of the period this time. And Kelly doesn't make the front end of this one and one. He nails it, though. 11 seconds left. Kelly Clark gives Summertown a five-point lead, 44-39, as he eyes the mark for the second free throw.
Shots up. It rolls good. Give it to him. Six-point lead, 10 seconds. Sean Churchwell coming across 10-second line. He finds Dave Morris. Morris puts up a 25-foot shot, and he's fouled by Kelly Clark with the body with 3 seconds remaining.
As that foul right there will have Coachman B just up in a tizzy down there from a three-point land. That's not a high percentage shot, and when a man gets fouled that far out, it really does work on the coach's health, I guess you might say.
Jason Morris going to the line to shoot two. First one's up, bounces, no good. Jason Morris, I believe it's maybe his first opportunity at the line tonight. He toes the mark for the second one. It's up. It's good. 45-40. Into Clark. Clark dribbling the ball. Puts one up. At the end of third quarter, Summertown 40, Clifton. Summertown 45, Clifton 40.
Hetrich feeding meal with hours 7 a.m. until 5 p.m. and open 6 days a week. Our proud to sponsor Summertown High School basketball. Neutrina Feeds are pleased to announce that Ethridge Feed and Meal, located on Highway 43 North at Campbellsville Road, is now open for business. We at Ethridge Feed and Meal invite you to stop in and look over our complete line of Neutrina Feeds. We also have Rose's Dog Food. Ethridge Feed and Meal on Highway 43 North offers custom grinding and mixing. We also have nails and a full line of nuts and bolts. Neutrina Feeds and Ethridge Feed and Meal on Highway 43 North and Campbellsville Road will appreciate your business. Phone 829-2144.
Fixing again the fourth period. Summertown with a five-point lead. Summertown still has Kelly Clark yet in place. Scotty Perry picked up his fourth foul there the closing seconds of the period. Over to Ivy, Ivy to Clark. Kidd on the left wing. Over the baseline, Gent back out to Kidd. Clark driving the lane, and he's fouled by number 14. That's four fouls on William Churchwell. Kelly Clark goes to the line, shoot the one and one.
each team coming up with some serious foul trouble here. William Churchill has been a catalyst for the Clifton team all night. He's not coming out of the lineup as of yet. He has four, and Scotty Perry for Summertown.
Shots up, no good, taken off by William. William over to Sean. Sean coming across the left side on the left wing in the low post for Bumpus. And Greg Ivey's all over Al Bumpus' back. So it's a third personal on Greg. So Al Bumpus goes to the line to shoot the 1-1. 7:40 remaining in the period. That's a third personal on Greg. Greg's sort of struggling tonight, but he's still playing as hard as he can go. First shot's up, but Bumpus is good. Al Bumpus, about a 6'2 jumping jack, puts the second shot up. It's also good. They're still in their full court press into Ivy. Ivy brings the ball across the 10-second line. He holds up, back out to Clark. Clark working ahead of the circle over on the left wing. Now the ball almost stolen. In the high post to Gent. Gent back to Ivy to Clark. Summertown with a three-point lead, trying to get something made into Ivy. Ivy has the ball flipped out of his hand, right back to him, puts up a 10-foot jump. No good. Summertown battling for the ball. Ivy picks her up. We had two men on the rebound that trip. Likely lost it. Ivy picked her back up over to Gent. Gent, 15-foot jump shot. No good. Rodney Long, tires high for the rebound. Has it blocked by Bumpus. On the run.
Oh, what a block by Chris Kidd on the other end. Oh, we got a late call by the referee here, but what a block. Chris Kidd hustling down the floor. The ball is released. His hand looked like he's up around the top of the square that time, Charlie, and he gets up and gets the block on. But as he came down, a little body came in contact.
Well,
picked
we
up the
we
foul.
Had a foul on Mike Jen on the rebound coming back down the floor. So
okay, so it was a clean block that time then.
So we go to the line to shoot the 1-1. Sean Churchwell. That's Mike's second personal. Sean goes to the line for the 1-1. Summertown's a three-point advantage. Ball comes off. Rodney Long brings the ball off the board. Tipped out of bounds by Kevin Cup.
Scotty Perry back into the ball game. With him out of the ball game, our offense was just flat there. We're needing him to run the offense and get the proper feeding. Summertown having some pressure, and there's Jason Morris reaching in with a foul, number 24 for Clifton. As Scotty Perry, realizing the time is running out on a 10-second violation, dribbles up the floor, and he'll go to the line and shoot a 1-1 now.
Scotty Perry is supposed to be our best free throw shooter. Goes to the line to shoot the 1-1. 6:40 remaining in the ball game. Summertown still enjoying a three-point advantage. It's been around 3 to 5 to 6 points about this whole second half.
I think it's going to come down to a real barn burn. These free throws are starting to mount up. We need to really hit every one that we can. And so does Clifton, and they are been hitting theirs. And Scotty Perry hits the first of his 1-1. Therefore, he'll be towing the line for the bonus.
Scotty at the line for the second personal. Puts it up. It's also good. Gives Summertown a five-point lead again. Summertown in a full-court press. Sean Churchwell bringing the ball up the left side. Going to go all the way to the baseline. And look like the victim of circumstance. Who did we get that time?
I bet he calls it on Scotty. I don't know. We're waiting for the call.
No, we got Rodney Long that time. We got another break. That's about the second break we got of the ball game. Scotty Perry drove him to the floor, and Rodney Long was there to pick up his second personal.
I guess the ref thought Rodney looked like he could knock him down a little bit better than Scotty could that time with his big body.
The ref appears to me that he don't have his floor presence tonight. And when he blows the whistle, he don't really know what's going on.
That's a foul whistle that time on Kevin Culp coming over the back on a rebound. That's number 4 on Kevin. And with that foul, Coach Doug Lambert calls timeout to have it discussed with officials. So with 6:30 left in the fourth quarter, timeout on the floor.
Scott's Grocery, located Highway 20 in Summertown, with Beth and Skim Scott, their owners. Scott's offers a full line of groceries, gasoline, and video rentals. Scott's also feature a game plan with fun and excitement for the entire family. That's Scott's Grocery on Highway 20, Summertown.
really starting to mount up for both teams here. Scotty Perry for Summertown has four. William Churchwell for Clifton, four. And Kevin Culp for Clifton with four. With this much time remaining in the ball game, that should have a definite major factor on the remaining part of the game here.
Rodney Long's line to shoot the 1-1 with 6 minutes and 30 seconds remaining. That's a long time to go. Rodney at the line to shoot the 1-1. It bounces, no good. Ball comes off to Al Bumpus. Bumpus over to Churchwell. Churchwell brings the ball up, works to the left side. All the way to the baseline, puts up a 15-foot jump shot. It's blocked by Long, taken off by Miles Holt, and Holt lays one up and in.
Clifton doing a good job on the offensive board there, and they've, after scoring, they go right into their pressure defense.
Perry bringing the ball across 10-second line over on the left side, back over the head of the circle, guarded closely by Sean. And the kid finds Long, pick and roll. Rodney Long had the man on his hip and quickly rolled him off and laid one in.
And give credit to Chris Kidd for seeing the position Rodney had and getting the ball quickly before the defensive man had time to recover, resulting in two Summertown points.
Old Al Bumpus, Al drives the baseline, lays it in. Caught Summertown napping, went in the back door. Perry working the ball across the 10-second line. Going to the right this time. Cut off on the right baseline into Long, Long, 15-foot turnaround. Give it to him. We set a double pick. Rodney picked off. And Scotty knew right where to put it.
Game getting a little more fast-paced here. Sean Churchwell down. He hits an 8-foot jumper for Clifton. Up and down the floor.
Brings the lead back to 3 with 5:08. First, third, fourth period. Oh, we got William coming back in. William Churchwell coming in with 4 personal fouls. It's do or die time, I guess, so we just will cover men in the game.
There, with William out of the game, Rodney's got 2 quick baskets down there. He's been able to shut him off most of the second half. Oh, they're putting back in to try to shut Rodney's recent fire off.
Perry bringing the ball across. Working the left side this time. Has the ball kicked. By Sean Churchwell. Summertown put her back in play. Chris Kidd, trigger man. Gonna go front court to Ivy. Ivy gathering the ball in. 2 men on him, working the head of the point. Coming around to the left-hand side, all the way to the baseline. And he's fouled by number 30, Al Bumpus. We're gonna shoot the 1-1. That's Al's third personal. 4:46.
Clifton really is seeing their man-to-man defensive pressure and really getting all over the people with their fine quickness that they're just playing, and they're really getting on the board as well. I believe this game's going down to the wire too, and as I said earlier, free throws are a big part of the game. Greg Eyes the first one, and he nails it, and so he'll be receiving the bonus with 4:46 remaining in the score. Summertown 52, Clifton 48.
Ivy's second shot, it bounces, no good, taken off by Sean Churchwell quickly up the left side. He's cut off a jet, just keeps dribbling. Ball picked off by Ivy. Ivy working the backcourt over to Perry. That was a good double team and steal. That one knocked him out of bounds, the other stole the ball. Over to Ivy on the right wing. He's cut off. Driving the middle. Puts up a 10-foot jump shot. Give it to him. Little Scotty just kept working until he got open.
Yeah. Scotty goes for the ball and almost picks up his 5th foul there. He needs to.
And to Sean. Sean over to Devers. Devers put up a 15-foot jump. No good. Chris Kidd brings the ball off the floor.
Summertown on a mini run here. They need to really get a good shot here and stretch the lead out to 8 or 9 points. We're going to be patient, try to punch the ball into Rodney Long or take it in from a wing position like Greg Ivy.
Ivy in the left corner, dribbled right corner, dribbled back out to Kidd. Kidd 30 feet from the basket, coming to the left side. Go down the middle, has the ball stripped by Devers. Devers 3-on-1, holds her up under Bumpus. Al Bumpus, 15-foot jump shot. It's up and in, and he's fouled by Rodney Long. That's his third personal. Al Bumpus goes to the line with 3:41 remaining.
That's a big trip down the floor. Summertown failed to score, which was 2 points, and then it come down, and Al Bumpus scores and pick up a foul on Rodney Long, a possible 5-point turnaround here. When we're like we had things going our way. Al misses the free throw. We can't get the rebound, though.
And Bumpus gets his own rebound into Churchwell. Churchwell, 18-foot jump, no good. Kidd goes high, bats the ball out to Ivy. Chris Kidd went high with the boys that time and bring the ball out to Ivy, over to Perry. Perry to Kidd. Has the baseline open momentarily. It's shut off. Has the ball thrown over to Ivy. Ivy brings the ball back to Kidd. Kidd over to Perry. Perry lays one up and misses. Long goes off the board and have on the back. Rodney Long. That's Rodney's fourth personal.
Well, getting a little vocal.
That official, I don't really know his name, but he's in no man's land. He don't know what he's going to call and don't know when to call it.
He's making a call late about every time, Charlie. One thing about an official, I can't say a lot about him. I won't get out there myself and do it. But you yourself being a former official, you know that if you're consistent, not anyone can put up with you. But if you are inconsistent in your calling, then that's when you really develop your problems.
Summertown had a snowbird, bad pass, throw it away. We can't get the break. We got a 4-point lead with 3:08 remaining. William Churchwell into Sean. Sean clearing everybody out. He's going to bring the ball the length of the floor. Looks like he'll probably go into about 12 feet over the middle. Put cut off over to Bumpus. Bumpus, 15-foot jump shot. Give it to him. That brings the lead to 2. Over to Perry. Perry working the ball in the backcourt. Brings the ball across the 10-second line. Over the free throw line. Over to Ivy. Ivy drives the baseline. Lays one up and in. Griggs just keep going after it. After a while, they're going to fall, and they did. That was a big basket. William, dribbling length of the court. He's cut off the head of the circle. Find Sean. Sean clearing everybody out. He's wanting to go to the baseline. Over to about Bumpus. Bumpus on the free throw line. Sean puts up a 15-foot jump shot. No good. Ball comes off the board. Picked up by Sean. Sean over in the corner. Hits a low post. Devers, Devers to Bumpus, Al Bumpus, 12-foot jump.
Summertown having some problems
getting
a defensive rebound down here. We're getting our hands on it, but we can't control it. And that time we should have had it. We had two men around and resulting in 2 points for Clifton since shot after the fine hustle by Sean Churchwell. He's coming out of the game right now. I don't really understand that move, but he's coming out anyway. He's being replaced by number 24, Jason Morris.
Summertown into Ivy. Ivy working back court to Perry. 1:56 remaining. Summertown with a 2-point lead. We're going to protect her down the left wing to Kidd. Kidd drives baseline, lays one up. It goes in and comes out. And William brings the ball down quickly down the right hand side. Goes all the way. He drives baseline, puts up a 5-foot jump shot, taken off the board by Holt. Holt puts one up, and he's traveled. Summertown has 3 men on him up there.
What a call in there. Summertown closed in on William. First made him miss the shot. Then second, they put 3 men around the man and made him make a turnover there. I thought for sure it was going to have a play on Rodney Long. And there's a bad call. It looks like Rodney Long dribbles the ball off of Miles Holt's foot. But apparently it didn't. And Henry Phillips with a call, and it'll be Clifton's ball with a 1:34 remaining. Summertown at a 2-point advantage.
Pine Knoll Landscape in Summertown. Larry McCrory, owner. Pine Knolls featured all type of residential and commercial landscaping and yard work. They will plant any type tree or shrub and will do any type yard work. Pine Knoll features grass seeders and have a grass straw blower to cover the seeds. Larry greatly appreciates your business. So for a free estimate of any type yard work, call Larry McCrory at 964-3514. Well, we'll set the court ball back in play. Looks like going to be Clifton putting the ball in play under their own basket. 1:34 remaining. Summertown still hanging to a 2-point lead.
Got Sean Churchwell back in the lineup for Clifton.
Ball into Sean. Sean working the left wing. He's wanting that 15-foot jump shot. He's trying to get it clear out over to Al Bumpus. Back to Sean. Over to William. They're working the 20-foot mark now. On the right side, William. William takes a 20-foot jump shot. It's long, no good. And Hope brings the ball off the board over to Al Bumpus. Bumpus, 15-foot jump shot. It's up. It's good. That notched the score with 1:08 remaining. Summertown brings the ball in. We have a foul on Al Bumpus. That's the fourth one on Bumpus. 1:04 remaining, 56-56.
Once again, a real barn burn here at Summertown High School on homecoming night. Greg Ivey, the senior, will be going to the line. He'll be shooting a 1-1. Like, as we said, 104 remaining, and the foul trouble began to mount up. But as of right now, as we said earlier, the fouls are pretty well academic. We just got to make our free throws, and if we don't, we got to get the ball and hit the shot.
Greg throws the mark. First one up. It's good. We put the senior at the line. They're supposed to produce, and so far tonight, the Summertown seniors are, along with everybody else. Everybody's playing a hard-nosed run-and-gun ball game. Ivy's second shot up, it's good. Summertown 2-point lead. Clifton quickly up the floor. Sean Churchwell working the left side. Within about 10 feet, working the baseline. Lays one up and in, and he's fouled by Rodney Long. And that's going to be the fifth personal on Rodney Long. And the basket's going to count. Timeout on the floor, 55 seconds remaining with the score tied.
The Community Bank and Trust, the Summertown branch, would like to take this opportunity to let the people of Lawrence County know that we appreciate our customers. The Community Bank and Trust offers a complete line of banking services with competitive rates on interest in all money market and certificate of deposit accounts, as well as low interest rates on all types of loans. We invite you, the people of Lawrence County, to visit any of our three convenient locations, downtown in North Locust in Lawrenceburg, and the Summertown branch in Summertown, and discuss any of their financial needs with our friendly personnel. So for personalized service, come and see the friendly folks at the Community Bank and Trust. Clifton will be at the line with Sean Churchwell. He will be attempting to complete a three-point play, which will possibly give his team the lead. Should his team get the lead, Summertown will try to come down. They have a couple of options. They can go for 2 points and try to retain the lead and put the pressure back on Clifton, or they could possibly go for a three-pointer and set up a two-point, therefore force Clifton to even more pressure on them. So it'd be interesting to see how they do it. Jason Bertrand, number 31, is the replacement for Rodney Long, as Sean Churchwell eyes the line.
Churchwell's first shot, it's no good. And Bertrand comes and goes high off of the board. Summertown bring the ball across 10-second line, 58-58 with 46 seconds remaining. Summertown setting up something. Clifton in a man-to-man. Rod Perry has the ball slip out of his hand, trying to find somebody, and it slips out of his hand.
Bryce Scott didn't take the shot then. Rocky had the shot open, but he saw Mike Jen in the corner, but Mike was fading out rather than coming to the basket, and the ball goes out of bounds, a floor mistake.
Sean bringing the ball across 10-second line, drives all the way down, cut off free throw line, back out to Buffett, back to Sean with 25 seconds. Looks like Clifton's going to play for one shot, maybe a timeout. They have two timeouts remaining, I think. Out 30, 35 feet out. William lays one up and in. Right down the middle, and he's fouled. Mike Gent picks up the foul with 14 seconds remaining. Clifton 60, Summertown 58. Timeout on the floor.
Catherine's Feed and Meal with hours 7 a.m. to 5 p.m. is happy to sponsor Summertown High School basketball on Channel 10. Etheridge Feed and Meal, located on Highway 43 North at Camelsville Road, serving all of northern Lawrence County, features a complete line of Neutrina feeds. We also have roses, dog, and cat foods. Etheridge Feed and Meal also offers custom grinding and mixing for their customers' convenience. Neutrina Feeds and Etheridge Feed and Meal on Highway 43 North and Camelsville Road invite you to stop in today or phone 829-2144. Clifton will be going to the line with William Churchwell to try to complete a three-point play. Should he complete that play, Summertown will be down by 3 points with 14 seconds to go. Look for them to try to put up a three-pointer, and the possible shooters for that would be Scotty Perry, Greg Ivey, or Chris Kidd. The ball goes up.
It's up. It's good. Summertown quickly inbound. Clifton falling back. Perry across the 10-second line. We need three. And the Kidd, 20 feet out. It's up. No good. 5 seconds. Ivy back to Kidd, dribbles ball out. They had Butterfingers, couldn't put the handle on the ball. One second remaining, Clifton has a 3-point lead and the ball. Clifton set the inbound in back court. The ball goes in, it goes length of court to Churchwell. Churchwell puts one up, That's your ball game. Clifton 61, Summertown 58. But it was a hard-fought ball game.
Both teams going up and down the floor with a lot of hustle there at the end. Looks like Summertown just got a little more over-anxious there at the end. A couple of defensive breakdowns and resulting in three-point plays. And then when we came down the floor, we didn't hit the first three-pointer. And it seemed like everyone was worried about the time running out, and it didn't go in for them. But a fine, hard-fought ball game on both teams' parts.
Been here tonight with Coach Jim and B, the head coach of Summertown High School basketball. And Coach, you really had a tough game out there tonight. These Clifton bunch was really ready to play you, weren't they?
Well, I'm telling you, it was tough. That's about as hard a loss as I can remember. I thought we played well. They played well. We played well. I felt like we had the game under control, and we just I really can't explain how it slipped away, but it flat slipped away.
Was there a turning point in the game, did you think, Coach, or was it just a gradual loss on your team's behalf? You seemed to have some key turnovers there in the critical situations.
Well, we did, but I'm going to tell you, I thought the turning point in the ball game was the over-the-back call with about 2.5 minutes to go against Rodney Long down here. That was a four-point swing. It took two away and gave them two. We would have been four ahead, and the ball game ends up tied. And, you know, it was... From my point of view, and I could see it as well as the official because he was right with me, you could see daylight. You know, the guy just blew it, but you're going to have some. But it seems that lately, buddy, we get them at just the critical time, and that one was a critical call that I felt like it determined the outcome of the game.
Well, it certainly put Rodney in foul trouble, and then a couple minutes later, he fouled out there at the end, and you didn't have an offensive threat there at the end. Talk about the last play of the game, Coach, the three-point shot. Were you trying to set up for a three-point shot?
Well, yes. You know, we were three down. We had to set up. We intended, if they didn't come out, we intended to take it. We intended to go inside and pass it back out. We did that. We should have gotten three shots. I think we ended up getting one and mishandled two other passes. You know, maybe we could have hit one out of three, but I'm telling you, there must be a snake around here somewhere because we feel like we're snake bit right now.
Well, this puts you in fourth place in your district. If a win tonight would have guaranteed a third place for you, a third place tie with Clifton as of right now. It looks to me like you're coming on for a tournament team. This is three or four close losses for you, and it looks like they're going to put it together sometime later in the season.
Well, you're right, Ed. We've played five good ball games, and we've run into a little foul trouble in the last quarter. We're still running into fouls and fatigue in the fourth quarter. The three Fs, fouls, fourth foul and fatigue, you know, and it's we just can't overcome that yet, but we're gonna stay after it, and maybe we can sneak up and zap somebody at a good time. So we're just trying for that.
Well, Coach, good luck in the future, and we thank you for you stopping by tonight, and hope you put it on your next opponent. Who will that be now?
Well, we play Mount Pleasant up there Tuesday night, and then we've got a big game here against Waynesboro Friday night. We hope to see y'all there.
Thank you very much for stopping by, Coach. We also have with us tonight Coach Doug Lambert, the head coach of the Clifton Lions. And Doug, welcome to our program tonight.
Thank you.
Doug, describe the play of this ball game that you just had here. Your team really played well, looked like, against Summertown tonight, with the ball game going right down to the wire and you escaping with a three-point victory.
Well, I thought when it got down to crunch time, we played well. I didn't think, well, I know for a fact we didn't play as well as we played at times this year. I thought the game was a little ragged both ways. You know, both teams that looked like wanted to win it so bad they were making mistakes that we shouldn't make this late in the season.
Could that not be attributed, though, to the pressure defense that both sides were putting on? Both sides were using their quickness advantage and using the pressure man-to-man defense.
Well, yeah, that has a lot to do with it. You know, anytime that you're out there in those passing lanes, it's going to cause some turnovers and stuff unless you're a real smart ball club.
Coach, you're in third place in the district right now. How do you figure you're going to wind up come tournament time?
Well, since Perry County beat Waynesboro the other night, it looks like we're going to end up in third. And really, second and third, there's not any difference. The number two team plays the number three team. Waynesboro, you know, has got it locked up, looks like. But
do you feel, who do you feel is the best team in the district? You've faced everyone so far, haven't you?
Yes, we've played everyone. I don't know. There's not a whole lot of difference between I'd rate Perry County and Waynesboro, either one, on a given night. I'd say they're the two best teams in the district. And us in Summertown, just scratch, you know, it's just a matter of how you land third or fourth. I mean, you know, us in Perry County, us in Summertown's that evenly matched.
It seems to me on any given night, and one team could beat another all the way down through the top four teams.
I think so on a given night, but I think for us or for Summertown to beat those people, Waynesboro or Perry County, we have got to play a good ball game. We cannot play a mediocre game and beat either one of them.
Well, Coach, we thank you for dropping by, and good luck the rest of the season.
Thank you.
Here with Coach Philip Willer, the head coach of the Clifton line, the Clifton Lady Lions. And, Coach, welcome to our program tonight.
It's nice to be here, Eddie. Thank you.
Coach, you came out with a narrow victory here tonight, which really helped your team move up in the standings. Would you describe the play of your team tonight?
I felt like we played very well, Eddie. I really thought offensively we played an outstanding game. We shot the ball well. We moved the ball well against their zone. And I want to congratulate Coach Wyrick and Summertown. They've got a great club over here. It really surprised me. I knew they were playing extremely well from what I'd heard, but I didn't know they were playing quite that well. I thought we had a fine game, and they played an outstanding game. It was nip and tuck down the wire, and we were fortunate to get out with a win tonight.
You lost one of your main starters earlier in this year, and she was on the bench tonight, but she didn't even dress out. Describe, tell her name and what the problem is with her right now.
Okay, Eddie. Alicia Bumpus, she's a senior for us, 5'7". Girl that has really played outstanding for us. She's averaged 11 points a game, 7 rebounds, and has made the big play happen for us when we needed it this season. Alicia got very sick the other day, and they checked her blood pressure at 180 over 130. They rushed her to the hospital, and they feel like after a couple of days of tests that she has a valve that may be blocking. They feel like it could be a dangerous situation. They're sending her to a cardiologist in Nashville on Tuesday, and we hope, you know, that she'll be able to come back. Hopefully her health will just, you know, improve and be good. We'd like to get her back in a basketball suit because she's real valuable for us. But, you know, just so she's healthy, I hope she turns out fine.
How do you expect to finish in the district standings this year, Coach?
Eddie, I'd like to. We've got Collinwood next Friday, and I would like to do very well against them, and we have them at our place. I think we can play well. They got a great ball club. If we could come out second or third, this win tonight goes a long way toward helping us toward that goal of ours. If we could come out second or third and match up with Waynesboro in the district tournament, there's nobody we'd rather play, and I feel like, you know, that our kids would be very, very mentally prepared in that contest, so that would be something we're striving for. We have Perry County left, Collinwood, and Summertown, you know, comes down to our place. So we've got some tough teams ahead, but I feel like this ball club is gelling. We had a big win the other night over a great Richland club, who honestly, I think, you know, people don't realize it, but Summertown's right up there in their caliber as a team. Very fine team over here at Summertown. I really can't emphasize that enough. They need to be congratulated for their effort.
Well, Coach, we thank you for stopping by and visiting with us tonight, and good luck in the future games.
Thank you very much.
Also tonight, we have with us the head coach of the Summertown High School girls team, Bobby Wyrick. Bobby, welcome to our program.
Glad to be here.
Bobby, you came up on the short end of the stick tonight. Clifton came out with a narrow victory. Describe the play of your team.
I have nothing but praise for my team. The way we played tonight, we played head-to-head with a top-notch team in the state, and had a chance to win the game at the end if we hadn't got a break or two.
What do you think was the turning point in the ball game, Bobby? Or was there a turning point?
Well, the big difference in the game was that they had us outsized inside. We just couldn't stop the big girl inside and contain the two outside shooters that hurt us throughout the game. At one point in the beginning of the third quarter, we held the big girl down inside and had the one shooter outside. And then some of this other shooter came somewhere and started burning up from three-point range, and we had to regroup again then.
And she did start hitting the Kelly girl. She started nailing there at the end. That did really mess your defense up. I noticed that. How do you expect to finish in the district now, Bobby?
Well, it's hard to say how we're going to finish. Every game in and game out, they're all going to be just like this one. They don't get any easier. They're all tough. Before tonight's game, we were 2-2. Clifton was 2-2, and Waynesboro was 3-3. And the way it looks, we're all fighting for second, third, and fourth place. Of course, we hope to finish second or third.
Bobby, tell us what kind of steps you're implementing to try to replace the loss of Sharon Long.
Well, in the first place, I feel like some of the players have took a step forward, and each player has tried and started putting out and playing a lot harder since with the loss of her. And I just feel like every player on the team has just really put forth an effort to play harder and play better, and I feel like we've done it.
Well, Bobby, we thank you for stopping by and talking with us after the loss tonight, and we wish you good luck in the future games coming up. That reminds us, next Saturday night, we'll be playing the Waynesboro Wildcats up here. And for a brief rundown, let's get the scores of the night's ball game and the boys' game. For Clifton, William Churchwell has 18 points. Sean Churchwell, 11. Kevin Culp, 4. Al Bumpus, 16. Jason Morris, 6. Miles Holt, 2. And Dan Devers, 2. For Summertown, Chris Kidd, 12. Greg Ivey, 13. Mike Gent, 10. Scotty Perry, 4. Kelly Clark, 2. And Rodney Long was the leader tonight with 17 points. As I said, next Friday night we'll be bringing you the game between the Waynesboro Wildcats, who are rated number one in the district in the boys and number two in the girls, against the Summertown Eagles. We hope that you will tune in for us. So until next time, this is Eddie Stebbins signing off for Charlie Mabry, Eddie Talley, and Channel 10.